The discussions were streamed live on Instagram and other online platforms, including RBA's websites, with the president interacting with a number of social media influencers, and discussions centered on Rwanda's liberation struggle as well as the progress the country has made in the last 26 years and what is being done to overcome anything that may hinder that progress.
At the recent executive committee meeting of the RPF, you talked about how you'll be handling issues of corruption and accountability, and how you talked about it has been interpreted differently by different commentators, and I think that I'm trying to ask whether you should give us some clarification on what you really meant.
This was President Paul Kagame's response to that question.
First of all, it's not the first of its kind. We have had these many discussions before. And along the path of liberation which we talked about, we have always tried to identify ourselves with good governance. And one of the central things we talked about was to fight corruption or bad governance as we go forward in this liberation journey. It's in the history of RPF. It's not a new creation. It's not something I invented yesterday. It's an RPF belief and principle.
The matter of what the people who liberated the country had to sacrifice was also brought up, and the president made a few clarifications.
Kuvuga ngo jewe uko ngana nta mfite ubushobozi bumeze butya.
What we sacrificed, including giving up notions of what else we could be, based on personal abilities, desires, opportunities, or resources. Each one of us chose to forgo all that, anything else we could have become and achieved, and decided to do that one thing that would give us back the right to once again have a country of our own. There are those who can focus on one thing and nothing else. The Rwandan president noted that though the country was liberated back in 1994, the struggle continues, and that it has now taken on a new face, that of striving for economic development and preserving all that has been accomplished. The African leader also touched on the threat that is the COVID-19 coronavirus pandemic, noting that no man is an island when it comes to fighting this threat, and that it is impossible to find all the answers in one place pertaining on how to defeat it. No one individual, official, or country claims to have all the answers. No one in this world can claim that. What matters is that we allow science to guide us on this endeavor, help us to better understand the nature of the threat we now face, how people can protect themselves from it, and what those who are infected must do to survive it, and how they can be assisted to do so. That is why cooperation is necessary, both within individual countries and on a global scale between nations. Countries must complement each other's efforts to mitigate its effects and minimize the harm it can have on people. The discussions come a few days after Rwanda celebrated the 26th anniversary of her liberation, the first time this has been done amid a global pandemic. President Kagame has stated that he intends to find the time to write a book chronicling Rwanda's liberation struggle, a task he intends to undertake with the participation of others who played key roles in the country's liberation.